Good morning, dear students, and I'm happy to welcome you all to today's zoology class. So today's topic is parts of excretory system. In our previous class, we had started this lesson, excretory system, right? So you have studied the introductory part in your previous class, and in this class, you're going to learn about the parts of excretory system in detail. What are the parts present in excretory system, we'll be learning. I told you already in the previous class that every excretory system varies. Similarly, human also have a unique excretory system. About that only we'll be learning in today's class. What are the four parts of human excretory system? The four parts include kidneys, ureter, urinary bladder, and urethra. What are the four parts in human excretory system? Kidneys, ureter, urinary bladder, and urethra. Okay, so we are going to learn the structure about these four parts and the functions in detail in this class. Okay, so first we'll learn the basic properties of kidneys. So where are the kidneys? Before that, do you know that kidney is a V-shaped structure? So wherever you are asked to locate the kidney, there is a simple trick. Wherever you find a V-shaped structure like this, like a beans, whatever you find, that is the kidney. Where is that structure here? So this is the kidney, right? So this is one kidney and this is the other kidney. So how many numbers you have, how many number of kidneys you have in your body? You have a pair of kidneys. What is pair? Pair means two, right? See, this is one and this is one. So what is the number of kidneys? They are, the number is two, or it exists in pairs then. What is the color of the kidney? It is brown or reddish brown in color. So it is brown in color with a red shade. Okay, some red and brown color mixed, that type of color you will have the color of the kidney. So you'll have a red shade as well as the brown shade mixed together, that is the color of the kidney. And then what next? Where is it located? Where can you find the kidney? It is above the waist, it is above your hip region. And then specifically, both sides of your backbone will have one kidney. You have your backbone, right? The spinal cord. On both the sides, you have one kidney. It is above the waist region, above your hip region, and on both sides of the spinal cord. And then the right kidney is lower than the left kidney. The right kidney is lower in position. Actually, it is not like on the same region. The right one is lower and the left one is slightly above. This is how it is positioned. Okay, next we learn the detailed structure of a kidney. So I told you kidney is bean shaped structure, right? So in this bean shaped structure, if you cut the structure, okay, if you have a bean shaped structure, if I cut it equally into half and display, you will have all these structure inside. Okay, so the previous structure was the outer structure. When you cut it, you can see all these parts inside the kidney. What all a kidney has? There are two regions called as outer cortex. The outer region is called cortex. Where is the cortex here? See, can you see this region? This is the cortex. This is the cortex, the outer region. And can you see this inner region? This is the medulla. Outer cortex and inner medulla. See, actually the description is given as outer area is darker and inner area is lighter, which means this is supposed to be dark and this is supposed to be light, right? But in this image, the shades are given in a wrong way. So that's why it is yellow here and brown here. Actually, in a real kidney, the outer cortex area is darker in color, inner medulla region will be lighter in color, just keep in mind. What next? You have one more structure called as renal pelvis. What is this renal pelvis? See, can you see a tube here? This is called renal pelvis. It is present in the inner cavity. Why it is called inner cavity? I told you already, kidney is bean shaped structure. No, see, if the structure of a kidney is like this, there is a inner cavity inside which is concave. This shape is called concave. If it is this way, it is concave. If it is going to be this way, it is called convex. Okay, in mirror, in physics all you must have studied, right? So this is now concave in shape. And then what is renal pelvis? What other properties? It is also funnel shaped. So I told you renal pelvis is located in the cavity of the kidney and it is funnel shaped. Can you see this shape, how it is? It is like this. So it is like this, right? That is why it is called funnel shape. What is the shape of funnel? Usually it is like this, right? The shape of funnel is like this, almost like this. It resembles like, what they mean is it is broader in this area and narrow below. So it is described as, it is funnel shaped structure and it is concave. Which is concave? The renal pelvis is located in the concave region. And it opens to the ureter. Where is the ureter? We will be learning about the ureter in the next slide. Okay. So what all we have studied about the structure of kidney? It has the outer cortex region, this yellow color region, and inner medulla region, this brown color region, and it has a renal pelvis, which is a tube which is found in the concave region of the kidney. And the renal pelvis, or this tube which starts here, is in the shape of a funnel. So that is all we have studied in this slide. What next? What all parts you have? You have studied about the structure of kidneys. What else you have? There are four parts, right? What is the next part? The next part is the ureter. I'll show you. So what all you know now? You know the shape of the kidney, right? So this is the kidney, this you know. And you also know, what is this? This is the renal pelvis. So this also you know. What is ureter? You have a long tube here. No, this is the ureter. You have a pair of ureters here also. You have ureter, right? So this is also a ureter again. So let's learn about the structure and functions of ureter. So it is a pair, again like a kidney. Like kidney, you have two kidneys, right? Similarly, ureter also, these tubes also are two in number in your body. They are in pairs and they are the tubes. Okay. What else? It originates from the renal pelvis. In the previous slide, I told you the renal pelvis opens into the ureter. The same point they have explained in some other way, like the origin of ureter is the renal pelvis, which means the origin of ureter. Origin means, what is origin? From where it starts? Where does the ureter start? It starts from the renal pelvis. So this is the renal pelvis, right? So this region is the renal pelvis, a tube which is present in the concave region of the kidney. So this opens into the ureter. That way also you can explain, or else you can explain, the ureter starts from the renal pelvis. Okay. So this is the explanation part. And what is the function of ureter? The function of the ureter is, it receives urine from the kidney. So the function of kidney is to filter the blood and separate the urine. You have blood with waste, right? So it will filter the waste from the blood and it will release out the urine. So after this, urine comes to the ureter through this tube. So the function of this tube is, it will receive the urine what the kidney gives. Okay, after receiving, what it will do? Can it store? No, it is a very small tube, right? So it cannot store. It will give it to another bag like structure called as urinary bladder. So which is the urinary bladder? Can you see a bag like structure? This is the urinary bladder. So it receives urine from the kidney and gives it to the urinary bladder. So transports urine to the urinary bladder, receives from kidney and gives to the bladder. So this is all about the functions and structure of ureter. So next you are going to learn about urinary bladder. So about this structure you're going to learn. What do you know by seeing the structure? What can you understand about urinary bladder? It is a bag like structure. Can you see, like, it is like a pouch or a bag, right? So the urinary bladder is a, let me rub this, or it is clumsy. Okay, so where is the urinary bladder in this slide? So this is the urinary bladder, and it is a muscular bag. Why it is described as muscular bag? Of course, when you see the structure, it is like a bag like structure, but it is all made up of muscles. It is not made up of cloth, it is made up of muscles. So it is called as muscular bag. And then where is the location? The location of urinary bladder is below the ureter. This is the ureter, right? So below the ureter only you have urinary bladder. So the location is mentioned as below the ureter. And then what is the function of urinary bladder? To store urine. What is the function of urinary bladder? The kidney filters and gives the urine out. So the ureter receives the urine and gives to the urinary bladder. So this urinary bladder is a temporary bag which can store the urine until you pass out the urine. So it receives urine from the kidney and it transports the urine to the bladder. The next part is the urethra. Where is the urethra? Can you see this region below the urinary bladder? Can you see this structure? One more tube like structure. This is the urethra. Okay, this tube like structure below the urinary bladder is called the urethra. Let's learn the properties of urethra. What is the function of urethra? It is again described as a muscular tube. I told you it is a tube like structure, right? This tube is made up of muscles, so it is described as it is a muscular tube. What else? Where is it located? It is located at the end of the bladder. So this is the bladder, that is urinary bladder, and at the end of the bladder only urethra is located. So what is urethra? Urethra is a tube. This is a tube. It is located after the urinary bladder, at the end of the urinary bladder. What is the function of urethra? So whenever it is relaxed, whenever the tube urethra is relaxed, the urine is released out. Okay, so if you have a tube and if you pour a liquid inside, it will come out, right? So when there is urine in the bladder, why does it not come out always? Because this tube is controlled by a special muscle called as sphincter muscle. What is the name of the muscle? It is called as sphincter muscle. This sphincter muscle is present in the tube, that is the urethra. So whenever the sphincter muscle allows the urethra to relax only, you can pass out the urine. Otherwise, when the sphincter muscle is contracted in position, urine cannot be released out. Okay, so the process of expulsion of urine, the process of releasing urine is termed as, it has a technical term called as urination or mixed urination. So the process when you pass out urine, that process is technically called as mixed urination or urination. Okay, so this is about the structure of urethra. Next we learn about the functions of kidney. Okay, what are all the functions present in a kidney? The first function is, I told you already, it filters the blood. Why it has to filter the blood? What does your blood contains? Why it has to be filtered? Because in our previous classes I have told you, when I was talking about metabolism, I told you where metabolism happens. Metabolism happens in every cell of your body, and there are many many wastes produced by the process of metabolism. So where these wastes are all present, they are all dumped in the blood only. So the blood has to be filtered or purified on a regular basis or periodically. So what happens is, when a blood is filled with metabolic waste, it is entering the kidney, and the kidney acts as a filter to remove the waste, and again it will send the pure blood throughout your body. What did I tell you? your blood has many metabolic ways, and these ways has to be removed periodically. So this blood enters into the kidney, where the kidney filters the blood and removes the waste and sends pure blood to all other parts of your body. So the main function of kidney is to filter your blood from the waste materials. And then some description of urine. What is the color of urine? It is straw color, that is pale yellow in color. And what all urine contains? It contains urea, salts and dissolved waste. When I talk about waste, no, don't imagine there are big particles in your blood. No, you cannot see, because the waste is in the dissolved form. Okay, so what all urine contains? Urine contains urea, salts and dissolved wastes. What else? And okay, you have two structures. Can you see two colored tubes? We have already studied about renal pelvis, ureter and urethra. All they are all tubes, right? But two more tubes you have, one red in color and one blue in color, right? So this red colored tube is called the renal artery. So what is this actually? It is a branch of aorta. See, when you study about the detailed structure of your heart, no, you will find a tube, a big tube called as aorta. Okay, so that aorta branch is only this renal artery. Okay, so what is the function of this renal artery? It carries metabolic waste to the kidney. So what did I tell you? Renal artery means from your heart there is a tube called as aorta coming out. So the branch of aorta is called the renal artery, and this renal artery only, what it does, it carries the, I told you about metabolic waste in the blood, no? So this renal artery alone carries the metabolic waste from all the parts of your body, and finally what it does, it enters into the kidney. So this renal artery enters into the kidney, it takes the blood into the kidney. So the direction of flow of blood is like this. So from the heart, this tube starts from the heart, it will collect waste from all parts of the body and it enters into the kidney. There is one more blue tube, no, that is called as renal vein. What is the name of the blue tube? It is called as renal vein. Renal vein. So this blue tube is called the renal vein. It carries blood from the kidney. After blood enters into the kidney, what happens? It is all purified, right? The blood is purified, and the purified blood is carried away by the renal vein to all other parts of the body. Okay, so what is the function of the renal vein? It is free of metabolic waste. Why it is no metabolic waste is present? Because already the blood has been filtered in the kidney. So renal artery carries blood which has so much of waste in it, and the kidney, after filtration, the blood comes out through renal vein which has no more metabolic waste. This is the main function of the kidney. Okay, then one more structure, important point is your kidney is fully made up of small blood capillaries called as nephrons. Okay, or you can call as the units of kidney. We have already studied about two tubes which carry blood. One is called renal artery and the next one is called renal veins, right? So this renal artery, which is the renal artery, this is the renal artery, right? So this renal artery is branched into so much, like sub branches it will give inside the kidney, and these branches are called as nephrons. So the renal artery branch into nephrons. This tube which carries the waste will branch into many small tubes, and these small tubes are only called as nephrons. Okay, but these nephrons you cannot see with your naked eye because they are microscopic units, and these nephrons are only those responsible for filtering the blood. So they are called as filtering units. What did I tell you? This renal artery is branched into small tubes called as nephrons, and these nephrons are called as the filtering units, and they are microscopic, which can be seen only through the microscope because it is very small tube and you cannot see with your naked eye directly. You cannot see. They are surrounded by capillaries. What are capillaries? Capillaries are again blood vessels. So these nephrons are surrounded by many capillaries in them. Okay, and the last part is in your blood. So always do not think that blood is only made up of full of metabolic waste, because there is so much of metabolic process in your body. Blood do have metabolic waste. Along with that, when you eat, when your food is digested, it is absorbed by the blood, right? So your blood will also have useful products like glucose, amino acids, and useful minerals such as sodium. Na stands for sodium, K stands for potassium, and Ca stands for calcium. Okay, so these products, when blood flows into the kidney, no, it is filtered, right? But it will not filter this and send to the waste as urine. These useful products in the blood, that is glucose, amino acids and minerals, are reabsorbed by your blood. What is this reabsorption? They are again taken into your body by the blood. It is not excreted out as the waste through your feces or through your urine. It is reabsorbed. It is taken back into your body and it is used by your body. So just remember this concept also. So for your homework part, what you are going to do is read from pages 90 to 91, read, and in page number 91 you have 5 questions. Please do solve these 5 questions, and as usual send me to my WhatsApp number. Okay, so this is all for today's class, and until I meet you in one more class, you all take care and bye bye.